Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Sale, the High Level Queen, and today we are going to talk about how to convert your high level pipeline into a sales machine. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Okay, the first thing that we're gonna do to turn your pipeline into a sales machine is talk about the sales funnel. Now, this may seem pretty basic considering you guys are marketers, but we see this done wrong time and time again, and we want to make sure that you are set up for success, okay? So a sales funnel is a guided path that prospects are going to move through to get to the sales process and ultimately make you more money, okay? And there's different steps here, and you're going to see why I'm showing you this in a second, okay? So you're going to start with awareness. Oh, but look at this pipeline stage. Prospecting? Okay. Oh, and then stage two, discovery. Pipeline stage. Oh, there's three pipeline stages here. Stage two, qualifying leads. Stage three, initial meeting. Stage four, define prospect needs. Okay. Sales funnel stage number three is evaluation. And that maps to stage five, make an offer. Now, I'm telling you this because the way that high-level team designed the pipeline and the dashboard reporting was to go through this process, which means ultimately if you set up your pipeline the way that I see a lot of people set up their pipeline, new lead, and then booked appointment, and then no show, and then lost the deal, you can see how that does not map correctly through the stages of the sales pipeline, okay? Stage four, intent, is going to map to stage six, negotiation and finalized proposal. Five, purchase maps to seven, closing the deal. Six, loyalty maps to eight, deliver the product. So you're going to want to keep this in mind when you're designing your pipeline. Now, I'm not saying that you need every single one of these, okay? I'm not saying that at all, but make sure that every stage down the line is one stage closer to the sale. Hopefully that makes sense, okay? Step two is we're gonna set up the pipeline correctly, okay? Now, I just wanna show you one of my pipelines really quickly. You can see that I'm on the dashboard and that I had 172 people enroll that raised their hand to say, I'm interested in your bootcamp, okay? Out of that, 57 made a deposit. Okay, now this says 56 joined the wait list. Now, technically, the wait list should be up here, okay? But I'm showing this to you guys to show you, number one, I'm not perfect, and number two, how it messes with your numbers, okay? And then look, group two, 36, roadmap session scheduled, 36, 136. Does that seem right? Let's look at this again. So these numbers, you're going to be including what was in the previous stage here. Okay? So we don't actually know if this 36 was like the same 36 for all three stages. We're not sure. Okay? So we can go over here to opportunities and look, and you can see that there was 17 that scheduled a session, 8 in group 2, 20 on the wait list. Okay, so if we do a little bit of math, 17 plus 8 is 25. Okay, so there's 25 people in these two, plus 20 is 45. So if we go back here, our numbers aren't adding up, but that's because we didn't set up the pipeline correctly, okay? So what we're gonna do is set it up the right way, and I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. how you set up your pipeline correctly. Go to settings, go to pipelines, create a new pipeline. And you can name it the right one or whatever you want to name it, okay? Something that you know you're going to know what it is, all right? And then here, we want similar pipeline stages, okay? So I'm going to move this over to the side so I can still see it. And one is prospecting, so I always call that lead in. You can call it prospecting if you want. Okay, two, qual call, okay? It could be a demo meeting, or it could be defining the prospect's needs, okay? So the most common one I see is qual call, which is a qualification call. Okay, whoops. Okay, then the next one, we're gonna say, we're gonna do a demo, okay? Then we're gonna say, let's see, offer made, okay? Now we can do all kinds of cool things with these, like do different automations or webhooks when these cards are moved. Stage six is negotiation, finalized proposal. So proposal sent. And then this is closing the deal. So I always call that one. And that basically just marks it as one. And then the next one is deliver the product. Now, I don't usually include that because I actually make it a completely different pipeline for my paying clients. And the reason why I didn't do that in my earlier example was because that was a digital product, so it's not an ongoing thing. If it's an ongoing thing, I have a completely separate pipeline for my paying clients, okay? Now, we've got it set up the right way, okay? We even called it the right one. Now, step three is you want to set up your triggers. Go ahead and go to triggers and click on add a trigger. Now, this is gonna be a little tricky because we want to make sure that we have the right amount of triggers for each pipeline stage, okay? Now, I'm going to show you how to do one, and then you can use this same process over and over again for the other pipeline stages. So, you're going to want to name it something that matches with your pipeline stage so you know what the heck that you did when it's tomorrow or next week or next month, okay? So, I am going to have one called pipeline and actually, I like to number at the beginning because it makes it easier to find. And I recommend doing folders too, but I'm not going to get into that here. Okay, so this is going to be when a lead first comes in. Now, you have a bunch of different ways a lead can come in, but let's just say that they submitted a form to come in, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to add update opportunity, and we have our pipeline now, and that's lead in. Now, super, super important, okay, here, you want your source, so I'm going to say form, and then my lead value, guys. This is key right here. This is key to making sure that your pipeline is set up for a sales machine. You're going to want to put your lead value in here. And if you don't, like, just use your average customer lifetime value, okay? If you don't know that, go look that up. I'm not going to get into that in this video, okay? And then our status, this is open because they literally just came in the pipeline, okay? Now, if you don't actually want to count a value until a lead responds positively, leave this blank right now and make another trigger for when they respond positively to this campaign, okay? But I'm just going to pretend like you want that there. Okay, then we're going to save it. Then you're going to want to turn it on. Okay, now that's our first one. And I'm going to actually reopen this because I forgot to add a contact tag. I always add a contact tag, guys. Form I add a contact tag on how, where they came in. Like, so this is going to be form. And then if you're doing like a bilingual campaign or something like that, you want to make sure that you put the language as a tag, etc. Okay, so for this one, I'm just going to do form. Then I'm going to do another trigger for when a client is marked as one. Well, I don't remember which pipeline state, what number it was. I'm just going to say that it was number six. If it wasn't, change it to the right number. Okay, so here, when we move someone in the one pipeline stage, and I'm just going to open it so I can show you again. Okay, so this, yeah, it is stage six. So whenever we move a card over here into one, we want to log that as a victory. So pipeline stage changed in the pipeline, the right one. You always want to add filters. Pipeline stage one, okay. Here, we're going to add update opportunity. And then we're gonna do status one, okay? You leave the rest of it blank. Now, if you have a second pipeline for clients like I do, I actually prefer to move them into the customer pipeline at this point, or you can just clone the opportunity, and I'll show you how to do that. So we're also gonna add an opportunity into the customer's pipeline. Now, this only has deposit paid. I'm gonna leave that for now. And in lead value, it's gonna be whatever it was, whatever your average customer lifetime value was, okay? And then here, if they're in the customer's pipeline, I typically don't mark them as one just because it's a total pain to try to find them later and then you forget that the dropdown is not working correctly, okay? So if you're lost now and like I'm talking crazy to you, it's okay. Make sure that you select the pipeline there. Because I'm going to show you how to use your pipeline now, okay? So we set this all up, and this is a different pipeline because I actually have real data here, but you use these to control the filters, okay? So if you want to sort by date, you do it there. This, I use this all the time. This is your pipeline dropdown. So whichever one you choose, this is the right one that we just made. Okay, now I can see that. Customers, that's a different pipeline. Bootcamp, that's a different pipeline. Okay, the other important one here is where it says all. So this is everyone. It's gonna default to open. So it's not gonna show you the people that actually pay you money. One, just gonna show you your paying customers. Lost, gonna show you the people that decided not to go with you and abandoned, same kind of deal there. You can actually, now this is really tricky and I don't usually do it this way because I always mess up and move it the wrong place, but you can drag them and see where it says one, abandoned or lost. You can drag them, but you run the risk of accidentally moving them over like this instead of down there like that, even if it's highlighted. So what I usually do is I just open it by clicking on the white space like that, and then I mark it like that, and it takes a little bit longer, but that's how I do a cleanup. So if for some reason my triggers were not using the one functionality like it is here, then I would just do a little cleanup on my pipeline just to see the numbers. And then going forward, this would fix it for everybody. Okay. All right. So that was step three, trigger setup. Step four, and this is one of the most important things that you guys can do. And if you guys don't take anything else away from this, except this step, this is what's going to make you money. Okay. Follow up with your partials. Now, you say, Christine, what is a partial? I learned what partials were from Rachel S. Lee, who's one of our clients and a friend of mine. She is an amazing person. If you don't follow her, go do that after this video. But basically, a partial means someone who put in their information on step one of your order form and didn't pay you money. Okay, that's what that means. So I bet you have a ton of these. If you use ClickFunnels or you use the high-level two-step order form, I bet you guys have a ton of partials and you don't even realize it. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how, okay? So first, in campaigns, we have a follow-up campaign. And this follow-up campaign was sent to every single person who put in their information and did not buy, all right? Basically, it says this. Hey, first name, it's Christine, so your name. I noticed you started the process to join our course, but you didn't finish. Are there any questions I can answer for you? That's it, okay? 20 minutes after. Now, I'm gonna show you the trigger. And simple is usually better, guys. Usually better, okay? The trigger is when a two-step order form is completed inside of one of your funnels, and it's an opt-in submission type, which means that they just opted in, but they didn't actually buy. We're adding a tag, calling them a partial. Okay, we're putting them in a pipeline into partials. We're removing them from the opt-in campaign, and we're adding them into the little one text campaign right here. That's all we're doing, okay? The reason why we're removing from all is because we don't want to continue sending them a different message series. Now, how do I make sure that the people that buy don't get this message? Well, you saw the 20 minutes on the campaign. So now, I'm going to show you that whenever there's a sale, see this sale? So you have opt-in, sale, or upsell. So the first one was opt-in, this one's a sale, okay? So when you have a sale, we're using a different tag, we're putting them into a different pipeline stage, and we're removing them from all the campaigns, okay? So we're actually, we think that within 20 minutes, if they're gonna buy, they would have bought. If they have questions, they're gonna take longer than 20 minutes. So we're removing them from all the campaigns. So they actually get taken out of that partial campaign and they get added into the purchase campaign. And then we remove the partial tag to clean it up. So that is how you turn your high-level pipeline into a sales machine by setting your pipeline up the right way and also following up with everyone who raised their hand and said they wanted to buy your stuff and didn't actually buy your stuff. I hope that helps. Don't forget to go check out our free Facebook group in the comments. I'll see you next time.